And I'll give you a good instance about how surfing was viewed back in those days. My dad, you know, he had his television show. I'm in Pepperdine. I came out of nowhere, man. I wanted to surf so badly, and I struggled at it. It took me over a year to learn to stand up. It was horrifying. I couldn't figure it out,
man. So you were living in Hollywood?
Hollywood,
surfing, yeah. Malibu?
Surfing with Clark Gable's son, John, whose brother was Bunker Spreckles.
Yeah.
And we stole Bunker's lightning bolt.
No way.
And took it on the bus to Santa Monica. And if he were here now, he'd kick our you-know-whats.
Yeah.
Right? So we would go and hang out at Malibu, and we were like 15, 16, right? And Danny Hilton, Paris's uncles, right? Bobby Darin's son. We all surf. And mom took me to Hawaii when I was 9. I stood up. Well, anybody can stand up in Hawaii, right? When they took me to Santa Monica, I mean, I was a laughingstock. I said, I know how to surf. I'll go with you guys. And I was humiliated, right? And then we went down to Tim Disney's house in Capistrano, Walt Disney's grandson. And I finally got it. It was through repetition. When I got into Pepperdine, I was at Third Point, and this is in like 1978 or 9. And I paddled up to Third Point. The first thing I see, I get in someone's way. Get the fuck out of here. Don't come back until you learn to surf. It was Alan Sarlo.
I was going to guess Alan Sarlo.
Okay, but there was another guy out there who surfed with his shorts around his neck, naked, Mickey. And he told me, don't ever come back until you learn to surf. You could not go to Third Point and be a kook. You can't have a surf school out there. You had to earn your spot there. And you know what I did? I was raised strict. I was raised to respect my elders. So I went to Sunset. I went to Sunset for a whole year, and I became a local there. And I met all the guys from Venice that frequented that point, right? And I got my sea legs there. And I remember going back up to Third Point and spraying Mickey in the face with my twin fin.
No way.
Yeah. I sprayed his ass. This is why, like, you know, getting bullied and harassed and, you know, it builds you.
Oh, yeah.
It builds you. You know, if someone said, oh, there, Johnny, I would have never had the drive to do what I did.
Right.
You know, and in a very short amount of time, I was the collegiate champion of the NSSA, of the Northern Conference. You know?
So, I mean, a lot of that discipline that your dad preached.
Yes.
It was embedded in you.
Yeah. But I was rebelling at the same time.
Right.
Because when I won the Northern Conference Championships, I called my mom and dad. I just won the NSSA Northern Conference Championships. I did a 360 in the finals with 300 people on the beach and kicked everybody's butt. And my mom goes, oh, we're so proud of you, John. We're so right. And my dad gets on the phone and goes, oh, you don't get enough exercise from that surfing crap.
Hilarious.
I was devastated. You know, like, you know, that was a tough one.
Yeah. You know.